Multi will go down. Looks like he's trying to get Queen all the way into the town hall. Zap Quake takes out the monolith and the poison tower. Yetis are gonna pre-trigger the other poison and maybe take out the single. Bro, what a plan from the man. Welcome your faces back, ladies and toast, to the next OP match between Na'Vi and Cha-Cha Esports here today. And this is in the Style Cup, which does have a pick ban system. Let me quickly find out which teams banned what troops for this particular match. So Na'Vi chose to save the Lava Hound. So both teams can use Lava Hounds. And Cha-Cha Esports chose to save Super Bowler. So Super Bowlers cannot be banned. Okay. Na'Vi banned Electro Titans. So we're not going to see any E-Titans in today's matchup. And Cha-Cha Esports banned Dragon Riders. Very interesting. So we're not going to see E-Titans. We're not going to see Dragon Riders in this matchup. That's pretty much the only rules. Everything else is pretty normal, classic stuff. Gaku coming in with an early Warden blimp on this Queen Charge Lalo attack. Oh. Ooh. Some of the balloons go left. He gets both Infernos. No, it's on 1 HP. Rip. He didn't get the single. I think he wanted both Infernos. That's why he popped the blimp right in between both of them. So, uh-oh. He already might be in trouble because remember, he doesn't have Warden ability for the rest of the attack. Warden's over here with the King, with the Royal Champion. This could get a little wonky with that single target Inferno Tower and the Poison Tower still being up. He has to still get the Town Hall, and he doesn't have very many spells left at all. Running out of spells fast. He rages the Queen, but it's late. Oh, wow. She didn't go to ability there. That was close. That's his last rage spell, though. King Royal Champion died on the top side of the base. This is going to get really sketchy. He still has Queen ability. She should be able to pick up the Town Hall as long as she goes inside the walls and not outside. She might actually path to the CC building. This is going to get really awkward if she does. She doesn't. She goes left. Smart Queen. She'll get the Town Hall with her ability. Now he has to think about how he wants to do this Lalo. No Warden to help out. He does have a Freeze and a Haste. Decides to send the Lava Hound from the left side. One balloon on the right. Just trying to pull traps, I think. It doesn't find any, though. Can he get it? Can he overwhelm the monolith and the poison tower? The poison tower goes to the queen. That's actually perfect because the balloons don't have to worry about the poison effect as they make their way around. Take the poison tower, take the single. Queen's even still alive. He timed it perfectly. Freeze on the monolith for the phoenix to stay up. Gaku actually saved this. Bro, what a plan from the man. Gaku, the captain of Na'Vi, kicking off this match with a 3-star. Cha-Cha Esports with their first attack, some Electro Dragon smash. Early battle blimp for the Town Hall. We gotta freeze that Invis Tower. He's not gonna use a rage, doesn't need it. If there was a tornado there, he could have been in big trouble. But it works. He got the Town Hall. Invis Tower is still up though. It's a little awkward, not that awkward, but it's a little awkward. Some rocket balloons to snipe that lower air defense. Do they get it? Yes, they do. Perfect amount of rocket balloons. Cool. Baby dragons to help funnel, and we're gonna do E-drags from the side over here. I think so. He zaps that sweeper facing over here. E-drags are in with the Warden. Queen on the right side to walk up toward the Eagle Artillery. We pop that Warden ability right away. Keep all those E-drags safe for now. There's the tornado trap spinning us in circles as we take out the defending Archer Queen. King being deployed with the Frosty to help assist that Queen. Poison Tower going off on the E-drags. Headhunter's going for our Warden. We're gonna hit the base up with the double freeze. Negate the damage of the single, negate the damage of the monolith, rage through it. Down it goes. The Warden got absolutely bamboozled by those headhunters, bro. Rip that guy. King and Queen on the right side still doing their thing. They both look pretty healthy. We still got the Royal Champion to help assist. Only one Invis spell left. Can these E-Drags get through the scattershot? No, I don't think they will. It's going to be up to the Royal Champion to get through that. If she does, the Queen should be able to finish off the rest of the base. Barbarians on the top side taking out that cannon. Champion still has her ability. We still got that invis spell. Why is Queen beating a wall when she can just walk around? Oh, she's throwing this attack right now. We go with the invis early. The skellies are going to go to the Queen. Finally, she heard me, and she's going to go around the wall. Another skelly trap distracts. Oh, can he even get through the scatter? Yes! The Seeking Shield takes out the scatter shot, and the Queen's going to be able to finish off the base. Why did she go inside the walls? And then beats another wall when you can go around again. Oh, my God. Bro, Cha-Cha Esports, y'all need to pay your queen better. Luckily, he's got so much time left in this attack because this queen is being an absolute goober. But the champion's still alive. All the defenses are dead. It's a 3-star for Cha-Cha Esports. And we are able to start this match off with a 3-star on both sides. We are all tied up. Here we go. Kazuma is in with the second attack for Na'Vi here today. What's he bringing? Some more queen charge. Lalo. Okay. Queen on the top side by the Eagle Artillery. He's got a log launcher currently activated. Cool. Valkyrie to help funnel on the left. Nice. Sneaky Goblin on the right. Archer Queen just doing her thing. Pretty sure we want her to skip the Eagle. Oh, actually, no. He's wall breaking her into the Eagle. Healers. She'll go toward the Eagle. King to go toward the Scattershot, and he's just going to log launcher the multi. All right, cool. Wants Queen to skip the multi completely. Log launcher will take it out. King going toward the scatter perfectly as planned. We can wall break Queen into the left multi. Wall breaker targets the perfect wall. Whatever's inside the log launcher can hopefully kill the enemy Queen. Royal Champion being deployed with the Barbarian King to help assist. Yetis come out. We drop the poison spell. There's super minions in the defensive clan castle. That's actually better for us in this situation. Better for the attacker compared to like a Lava Hound or something. Did he have an E-Titan in his log launcher? He did. I'm about to sneeze. My goodness, who just joined the Twitch chat? I'm definitely allergic to you, bro. E-Titan even gets through the Barbarian King with the help of a Headhunter. Nice. Queen did have to go to ability kind of early. That Rage Tower on defense is no joke. We rage up the Queen again, still trying to get her to get more value. Champion makes it all the way to the Monolith. She doesn't take it out. It was on 1 HP, but the Builder Hut repairs. Yeti on the bottom side will be able to snipe the air defense, and we have to Lalo through the Town Hall. The next rage on the Queen. Wall break does give Queen access to go around for the scatter. Will she live long enough to take it out is the question. We're full sending the Lalo into the Town Hall. Got one rage left. I think he's going to try to use it on the Lalo here. Yes, in combination with the Warden ability. Queen wrapping around for the scatter. She goes for the gold storage first. Can she take out the scatter before she dies? She only has one healer left alive. Balloons, hurry up. Get to the multi. The freeze is late. Queen goes down. Kazuma, his balloons are fizzling out. Ooh, I think the plan was good. If that freeze wasn't late, or maybe if he didn't use the queen ability early, this could have been a 3-star rip. This scatter shot's gonna kill all the balloons. The warden goes down. It's a defense for Dig of Cha-Cha Esports, and they've got a real chance now to take a lead with their next attack against Na'Vi. This is going to be pretty decent percent, though. Minions on the left go down. He should pick up the CC building. Does he have time? The Owl, the Headhunter are working on it. Owl gets distracted by Skellies. He might not get that CC now. That distracted the Owl for like a solid 5 seconds. Oh, 3, 2, 1. Yes, barely gets the CC for 92%. Mustafa with the second attack for Cha-Cha Esports. Some Queen Cha. Well, maybe not. Might be Warden Walk into Super Bowler Smash. Okay. All right. Here we go. Warden Walk on the south side. Probably going to be a Bowler Smash straight through the Monolith into the Eagle. There's the Flame Flinger on the 3 o'clock side of the base to set the other half of the funnel. Wall Breaker is successful. Just gotta let Warden do his thing for maybe a solid minute. Let him create a funnel here so the bowlers have nowhere to go but straight into the Eagle Artillery. No log launcher because he's using the Flame Flinger, but he does have 2 jumping spells to direct their pathing. You can already predict where they're gonna go. First one right over that Rage Tower, second one right over the CC building. Pretty simple plan. Let's see if it works out. Warden goes for that multi-mortar on the left. Flamethrower's still doing a great job of getting defenses on the right. I think he needs to get the wizard tower for the funnel to be really set. If he goes earlier than that, the pathing could get wonky. Baby dragon on the left. Warden's kind of low on HP. He's trying hard not to use a rage on the warden. No, he is going to anyways. Okay. There's the rage on the warden. Down goes the wizard tower. We should be able to start unless he really wants more, but he's running low on time. He wants the X-Bow as well. I think he's being a little greedy here. Oh, there we go. I feel like he wasted 5, 6, 7 seconds there by letting the warden get the bomb tower and not the X-Bow anyway. Oh well. Super Bowlers are in. That monolith locked onto the king right away. That's kind of unfortunate. King already going down. That's awkward. King's dead. We freeze the X-Bow to get the healers to switch off the warden. There's triple Ice Golem CC. That's going to stall us up for even longer. P.E.K.K.A. to P.E.K.K.A. come out of the Flame Flinger, but they don't path to the scatter shot like I think he wanted. He didn't funnel them in. That could cause problems here. We poison the enemy queen. Bowlers are making their way closer and closer to the town hall. We're just now popping the warden ability. Only 1:05 on the clock. Which side do we send the champion to? We send her to the lower side. All right, here we go. The upper scatter is still going to stay up, though, because the P.E.K.K.A. didn't go over there. Why did he bring 2 P.E.K.K.A.s in the Flame Flinger? I don't know. I feel like even Yetis get better value than the 2 P.E.K.K.A. Queen gets the town hall, but now the question is, how much value do we get after this town hall goes off and we walk straight into the Giga Poison? This is where these Super Bowler attacks tend to die off, is that Giga Poison just kind of kills everything. Queen gonna have to go to ability. She's fighting the king. She'll get him down. Royal Champion on the left already used her ability, and we have no more spell support. It's a defense for stars. Rip this attack. Queen goes down. Champion goes down. Warden with the healers gonna be able to grab a few extra buildings, but it is a defense. Kazuma got 92%. Can Mustafa match it? I don't think he has the time to. Maybe if he started that smash a few seconds earlier, he could have matched it. This gets really close, but less percent than Kazuma got. This one falls short at 87. Bernal is in with the next attack. Some queen charge bacon action. Ooh, look at this. 28 hoggies. Queen starting on the 12th side of the base. Giant king with the phoenix over on the right to go pick up that scatter shot. Cool. Queen, where's she gonna go? Down or up? If she goes down, that's awkward. She goes up. Perfect pathing. Oh, well, the expo is reachable. I wasn't even looking at that. She anchors off the X-Bow. Nice base identification from Bernal. King goes in, takes out the scatter shot, and that's honestly just wonky base building to leave all those defenses reachable from the outside. Look at this. Switches to a wall wrecker to go take out the Inferno Tower, the Queen, and should be able to trigger the second Poison Tower as well. I like this wall wrecker. I like it a lot. One Hog Rider takes out that Wizard Tower on the right. Oh, this wall wrecker, I assume it's going to be a Yeti bomb. It's going to get crazy good value. Walls get busted open. We rage it even. Yeti is going to absolutely slap that queen silly. Down she goes. They'll get the Inferno Tower. Poison Tower did go off on the queen. I think the Poison Tower would have been pre-triggered if he did the wall wrecker like 5 seconds earlier. But I'm criticizing when I don't even need to. It's looking really good so far. Rages the queen one more time. She'll take out the enemy champion. Now she can fight the CC troops. And where do we send the hogs? From the bottom side of the base. Here we go. With the champion, with the warden to help support, with the headhunters going for the king. We heal first. Gonna hold the warden ability for now. Queen has to go to ability here. Tesla farms over there on the left side of the base. He's got that one, or no, he already used his one and only heal. Poison Tower got a chance to go off again. He rages the queen, but the single target Inferno Tower. Invis just in time. She wraps around to the left. That's clutch. That means she's going to go help get some of these Teslas out of the way as the Hog Riders make their way toward the next group of defenses. We got to get through that monolith. Diggy to stun. Poison Tower gets to go off on the Hog Riders. Awkward, but I think he's looking good. He still has 2 freezes. He's got 36 seconds. Hogs get through everything. Champion has her ability. This is crushed for Bernal. What a plan. Perfectly executed as well. It's going to be another 3-star for Na'Vi. Bernal getting it done. Nice. Nice attack from him. Beautiful queen charge. Hog Rider. Cha-Cha Esports. is in with their third attack and pressure on them now. They need to triple to stay in this. Na'Vi with 2-3 stars already. Looks like we're going for a Blizz. Took the Wizards forever to start shooting that Town Hall, but they get it. Take out the X-Boat. Cool. Queen over on the bottom side of the base. It's a very simple Blizz. Just got the Town Hall, got the X-Boat, that's it. Didn't even get the CC pool. Is the value worth it there? You guys tell me. You guys tell me. We're gonna Sui the King and Queen toward the right side. Okay. All right. Ice Golem to help support as well. We got two Wall Breakers. Are we gonna send the Royal Champion to help with the heroes early, or do we try to save her for the Lalo? Let's see. Baby Dragon on the right, Headhunter to help get through the enemy champion. Next Wall Breaker is in. That'll give Queen access to the Monolith. There's the champion on the right side. Hound coming out of the CC. Poison Tower goes off. Hits the Queen. Queen gets in range of the Monolith as she's going to get stuck on the Hound. That's not good news. We start the Lalo. Full send on the right side. Here we go. He's going to need a Stars level Lalo to make this work, especially with the Rage Tower hitting all three Infernos. Whew. It's about to get dicey, and his Warden's about to snake him and stay with the King, isn't he? Bro, I have a tingly feeling that that Warden's just going to stay with the King. More Lalo collapsing in on the top side of the base. His Queen got wrecked. His Champion finally got through all the Lava Pups. She's making her way to the core. Monolith hits her, though. Do we dare freeze the Monolith? Keep the Champion alive. He's going to let her die. He's not paying attention to that Monolith. He's trying to freeze on the upper side, help the balloons get through this Inferno Tower. But he misses the Inferno with the freeze. Gets through it. At least he hit the Scattershot. Another haste on the top side of the base. One more freeze on the Mortar, because that's the thing that does the most damage to the balloons. Oh, we're out of spells. Everybody skip the Monolith. Poison Tower recharges. It's about to fizzle out. Uh-oh. This Monolith gonna kill everything. Locks onto the Phoenix, snipes her, takes her out. I think if he invested a freeze for the Monolith there and let Royal Champion get through it, this would have actually tripled. Down goes the air defense. He'll get through the Archer Tower even. It's literally just this Monolith that's gonna stop him. And maybe time. All of his cleanup died as well. But defense-wise, it's just the Monolith that stopped it, man. Rip this attack. How much percent can he rack up? Down goes the Wizard Tower. Down goes the X-Bow. If he had time, this would be like a 97% attack. But he's going to run out of time. Gets the gold storage. Warden Owl go left. That's actually good for him, so he can get an extra 2 or 3 buildings. Does he get that storage? No, 94%. Nice try, so close. Stars is in, the God of Lalo himself, with 7 lightning spells, no earthquake. I can tell you exactly where those zaps are going. Right here. Yep, woo! Too easy to predict. 7 lightning spells, takes out the Queen, takes out the Inferno Tower, and takes out the Sweeper. No earthquake needed. Is this the same base Bernal hit? With Queen Charge Hogs? It is, except this one has a Rage Tower instead of a second poison. Why are Cha-Cha Esports running 2 of the same base? That's interesting. Anyway, he's gonna do a Zap Sui Lalo. The Golem distracting the Expo, distracting the cannon as King and Queen are gonna take out the Town Hall Chamber. All right. All right. Yeah, the base looks identical, doesn't it? Town Hall compartment looks the same with those reachable 2 buildings. Queen pops her ability, takes the Town Hall. Scattershot compartment looks the same. We'll see if the Tesla farm's over there as well. Is the Eagle compartment different though? I feel like the bottom side is different. Or maybe I'm tripping. I think it might be different. King pops ability, taking out some more. Defense is over there. Super minions come out of the CC. We send the champion on the left. Want her to go get that scattershot. We use the poison spell. With the baby dragon, with the king, they should be able to take out a lot of those CC troops. Diggy stuns. There's the stone slammer. We start the Lalo into the Eagle artillery. Here we go. With the Grand Warden way down over there. Where is the Tesla farm? We still haven't found it. It's got to be on the right side on this version. That's interesting. It's like almost the same layout, but they changed the traps on both versions. Yep. There's a Tesla farm over there. So strange. We pop Warren ability. We haste our way into that last multi. We freeze the single for the champion on the top side. Last Lava Hound being deployed on the right. Distract the Scattershot. Distract the Tesla farm. This is crushed, bro. Nobody can stop Stars. It's Lalo, honestly. Ice Hound freezes up all these defenses. We still got two more freezes of our own. This is clapped all day long. Stars strikes again. Cha-Cha Esports run this base twice, at least two versions of it. I think they were slightly different, but neither of them work. So don't copy these ones, rip. Plenty of time left over as it's another triple for Na'Vi. Dig is in with some super bowler smash. Early Yeti bomb with the rage spell. Take out the eagle, get the CC pool. Do we get the multi as well? Yes, multi goes down. Healers on the queen. We can drop the poison spell to help her get through the hound. Help her get through the rocket balloons. Do they get a shot off on her? Is that going to do a lot of damage? Or is she okay? Oh, she's low, but she's okay. She's okay. And she's going to walk up. I don't think that's the way he expected her to go. I think he already sent a wall breaker and it died early. But it doesn't matter because he needs to go in on this side. That wall breaker works. Warden with the queen. Cool. Two ice golems. Bowlers are in. Baby dragon to funnel. Sure. Think we'll be sending king on the outside. Now, he's going to have to jump to give the bowlers access to the core. Access to the town hall. These healers are going to take quite a bit of damage from the Inferno Tower because he has to drop the jump way down there. I don't know how I feel about this plan. He's gonna have to pop Warden ability early to make this work. Monolith locks onto the queen. He pops Warden ability. Next rage is in. King moving through the right side of the base is looking good. Bowlers are bouncing. We get through the upper Inferno. Bowlers get to the town hall, but they're not in the rage. That's gonna cost us a freeze on the town hall. We will get through it. Queen trying to clear the core. Tesla farm on the left. Another rage tower over there can be very dangerous. Tornado trap hits the queen. She did not go for the left multi. That's also awkward. Queen goes to ability, takes out the enemy queen. Where do we send the champion? We still got king ability. We still got warden. We got two bowlers over there, or one bowler. I can't really tell. Rage tower goes off. That's actually good. I would say be patient. Let that rage tower expire before we send the champion over there. This might work out for Dig. And they need this 3-star to stay in the match. They have to triple their last two attacks here. Pops the king ability. Rage tower slowly expiring. We're gonna send the champion. Here we go. We got one invis, we got one rage. Do we use it on the champion? There's probably gonna be skelly traps. He does use it on the champion. There's a skelly trap. There's the invis. She goes for the scatter, takes it out right away. Gets the Tesla, gets the multi. This champion coming in clutch. Nice patience from Dig. It's gonna pay off. As with the RC ability, he's got plenty of time to get through the rest of the base. 14 seconds as the champion, the king. Wizards behind, still moving through. Warden's slowly getting there, but it's a triple. For Dig with the super bowler smash, nice royal champion value, and Cha-Cha Esports are still in this match. The man, the myth, the legend himself, Klaus Nos is in with Queen Charge, Hog Riders. Jeez, he saw Bernal do it and he's like, you know what? I can do it too. And I'm even gonna bring lightning spells on my Queen Charge Hog Rider attack. No healing spells on this one. Uh-oh. Queen on the bottom side. King a little bit to the right. How long can we delay those healers? Queen taking heavy damage from the scattershot. It's also hitting the unicorn off the bounce. There we go with the healers. Look at that minion to distract the air defense for one more shot. I like that. King setting the funnel. He's going to walk even further to the right. Hopefully take out the eagle. Can he? I don't know. We rage the queen. Oh, rip the queen ability. Scattershot gets a shot off on the unicorn, takes that out. King did take out the eagle at least, that's nice. Log launcher here is gonna clear this multi so the queen doesn't have to worry about it, okay? Cool. Multi will go down. Looks like he's trying to get queen all the way into the town hall. Zap Quake takes out the monolith and the poison tower. Yetis are gonna pre-trigger the other poison and maybe take out the single? Tell me they get the single. Tell me they get the single. I think they do. We rage the queen again. Healer's in the rage. She'll get the town hall. Yeti mites. Pick up the single target Inferno Tower. Yes! Look at this plan from Klaus! I'd say get started with the hogs before that poison tower recharges. Come on, bro. What are you waiting for? Go, go, go. There's the champion on the right side of the base. She's gonna have to get through the king, but we got headhunters to help her. Queen got the town hall. Now she's working on the expo. She's actually looking safe. More hog riders in on the right side of the base. Help assist that champion. There's the headhunter. We're gonna get through the expo. We're gonna get through the king. I think he should have sent like one or two hogs for that cannon. Queen might go down. Here's the rest of the hogs from the top side. We're going in, but CC troops are still there. That's a little awkward. We pop war and ability. We poison to help the champion. We send headhunters for the enemy champion. Freeze the scattershot, the bomb tower. What a plan. Is Queen still alive? Going for the wizard tower. She's gonna get that. We don't have any healing spells, but we freeze to keep the RC alive. She still has her ability. It's looking good for Mr. Klaus with the 3-star here. Na'Vi will pick up the W today. Over Cha Cha Esports. What a plan from Klaus. You love to see it, man. Very, very solid plan with the queen charge. Zap. Hog Riders gets it done, and Na'Vi with 14 stars today. Cha Cha Esports are in with some more Electro Dragons. Here we go. Battle Bloom going for the town hall. Double rage. Warden ability. Cool. Freeze on the Invis Tower. Rage. Down goes the Town Hall. Nice. Do we get the Invis Tower? No. Freeze the Monolith with the multi that's raged up from the Rage Tower. Rage the E-Drags on the right. Drop the Queen on the top side to go straight for the Barbarian King. Best air defense in the game. We gotta take him out, of course. These E-Drags are getting clapped, bro. That raged up multi does way more damage than you think. It's already almost shredded the Warden. King with the Queen now on the left side of the base. E-Drag's going for the multi. We still have the champion to deploy, but the entire core is still up. He's going to send a super minion to that multi. Excuse my cough. There still could be CC troops. It's probably Ice Golems or a Lava Hound. Both are pretty bad for a champion to get distracted on. That super minion did not pick up the multi. Uh-oh. This is looking like a defense. Decides to send the champion there anyway. She's... Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. Oh, dear heavens. Oh, oh? She picks up the monolith? That was a clutch invis. Then the freeze. Still not going to be enough, though. No more spell support. Phoenix brings the king back to life for a few seconds. Queen... already used her ability. Champion uses hers right there. The Warden Tower gonna take her out as she's distracted on the Ice Golem. Rip. Nice try to Cha Cha Esports on this one, but they are gonna be finishing with 12 stars today against Na'Vi. This one gonna get decent percent at least. 87, it looks like. As the minion goes down, not gonna be able to pick up that mortar. Archer dies, and it is indeed an 87%, so we can take a look at these stats. It's a win for Na'Vi, 14 to 12, 98.4% to 93.6.